nice crowd apparently. Welcome, teachers and staff. It's most of you. Nice to see you all. You will stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. We'll take comments from visitors.
Hi, Jill Boone, Fort Pine Street, co-president of Boston Education Association. I'm wondering if I could have permission to read a letter from the Boston Education Association.
A board? What's the pleasure of the board? All right, Jill, you can tell me about copies. Stand for your comment.
Dear Washington School Board, it is a great sadness and disappointment that we feel necessary to respond in writing to your proposal. The purpose of this letter is to bring forth our concerns regarding the proposal and its impact on the relationship between the Washington School Board and the Washington Education Association. We acknowledge that you've made an effort to at least partially address the financial inequities that recent years have brought upon five professional staff members at Washington Grade School by providing a one-time bonus. However, it's essential to note that as a board, you have the legal right to place teachers on their appropriate step based on years of experience by appropriating the funds into the general operating budget. This can be done legally without input or permission from a budget committee and or select board, and regardless of whether the contract is passed. In many other towns and school districts, teachers receive the appropriate steps regardless of whether the collective bargaining agreement passes. The one-time bonus that you've proposed is an incredibly small percentage of the amount that these individuals are entitled to based on their years of teaching experience. When you as a school board fail to grant steps to deserving employees, especially when there's an operating budget surplus of over $125,000, you are accepting and endorsing a gross injustice. The school board should commit itself to doing what is legal, just, and right by placing all employees on the correct step. Doing so will cost far less than what the school board overbudgeted for special education expenses. And there's a chart below that you refer to these five involved individuals. When each of the above mentioned staff members were hired, they were provided with a contract that outlined the pay structure. It is clearly written that for each year of experience gained, the financial compensation increases as noted by steps in the pay scale. For the past 7 years, this has failed to occur. Longevity has been awarded based on years of experience, but steps have not. Why has the school board chosen to ignore repeal of the Evergreen Law when it calculates longevity, but not step placement? This money is not just a number on the line of a budget. This money to which each of these five professional staff members affected are entitled is money that pays for mortgages, daycare, student loans, and more. Without using your legal right to provide the appropriate 30 years of experience, you are withholding real things from real people, causing financial strain on real families. In addition, it's incredibly devaluing as professionals and belittling of the effort and experience that these five members of the professional staff have dedicated to Toronto's grade school. In writing this letter, we are appealing to you to make the ethical and legal decision to provide the appropriate financial compensation to each of the five professional staff members based on the years of experience. Issue new contracts to those five employees, placing them on the appropriate steps, and show the community of Rollinsford, the staff of Rollinsford Grade School, and the students whose futures we together are shaping, that you will not allow this injustice to continue. We respectfully anticipate a response from you. Sincerely, Rollinsford Education Association. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, there's a lot there. Getting back to you at some point. Any other further public comment by the public? None? All right, then we will move on to our agenda. We, on the consent calendar, we have the minutes from our May 11th public hearing, our May 11th school board meeting, Rollinsford grade school letter, and enrollment for June. Letter from the board. Motion to accept, or do we have anything come up for discussion?
I make a motion to accept.
One second. You got to all that. All in favor of approving the consent calendar, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Announcements. Sure.
I could read to you, but you're all capable. There are a number of school events on the bottom, so I just would bring that to your attention that we have a lot going on between now and when the school ends.
There is a lot going on, yes.
Yeah.
Anybody else? Announcements?
Together and give out awards for academic or extracurricular excellence in some form. And
also do our annual teacher barbecue, which for us this year is on June 20th. It's always the last day after finals. This way to thank the teachers for all that they've done and just having a nice lunch to eat. And we also were informed of new advisors for our student council next year. So after 7 years of Adam Durkee doing it, it is now going to be Alicia Robleski and also Gail Griffith continuing on. And a new thing that our student council has taken on this year is to help with eighth graders kind of establishing their class officers before they come up to high school, so that way they don't have to spend time establishing all that. They already have those positions filled. Our National Honor Society has handed out our scholarships this year, so we handed out 5 to following students: Mariah Wachowski, Holly Morris, Jeanette Morassi, Avery Kretschmar, and Jamie Croto. As far as our class councils go, the freshmen are just busy attending a multitude of fundraisers. Our sophomores are selling t-shirts. They've had t-shirts all throughout the year that they've been selling, and they're now getting their senior send-off sale, which is going really well for them. They also sold water and popcorn at graduation, and they are planning multiple car washes, and they set their date and location for prom, so it will be May 19th at the Riverwell in Dover, which is really exciting for them. The junior class has planned 2 or 3 summer car washes as well. We're also doing Loudon in September. We are scoping out different senior banquet locations as well as project graduation ideas. And then a big congratulations are in order because our seniors actually graduated last night. And then tomorrow night is their senior banquet at Spring Hill. So our sports are done for this year, but we had a meeting today regarding next year's ball sports. So we have all the forms handed out for that, which is nice. And then our guidance department is sponsoring a college boot camp to be held on August 21st and the 23rd, in which we'll go over college essays, what to look for when you're going on college tours, and you're just researching colleges in general, how to fill out your applications, and then scholarships as well. So it's covering all the bases, which is a great tool for us. So,
thank you. Now, refresh my memory. You will be a senior next year?
Yes.
And Noah, you will be a senior next year? But it also means you both have studying to do, probably. Finals coming up and all that. As usual, you are welcome to stay if you would like to, or you are excused if you have other things present that you need to do. Thank you both very much. It's but, you know, like that time of the year. Maybe present. All right, now we're on to action items. The first one is our agenda is to, an item to allow the superintendent to do summer hiring. Jenny, do you want to just address
sure.
that?
Sure. So in the past, each year you afforded me the opportunity that if any summer hiring needs to happen, that I can move forward and then bring it to you in August when the first meeting occurred. You never know what can happen in July, so instead of trying to gather everyone and allow that to happen, to really give the authority to the superintendent to do the hiring, and then I would certainly share that information with you if it happens in August at the first meeting, or the superintendent will share that information with you, not this superintendent.
All right, any questions or concerns from the board on that?
So does the circumstance arose that you need to take care of that?
And then what
like happens? For example, you know, a teacher decides to leave in July. So Kate and the committee goes through and comes up with a candidate. I meet and interview the candidate. I can offer them the position, not saying it's tentative until the board meets in August, because they may get an offer elsewhere or take a job elsewhere. So it allows me to say, you're set, I can hire you. And then I just bring you the nomination form like I typically do when we're doing that.
Any other questions? Mm-hmm. All right, then a motion, please, to, I believe we need a motion on that.
Correct, yeah.
A motion to allow the superintendent to do some hiring.
I make a motion to allow the superintendent to do the hiring. Okay.
Second. All right, any further discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Second
thank you.
You're welcome. Second action item is an update to the Rollinsford school calendar for 17-18.
Yeah, so
go ahead.
I'm sorry. So Kate and I have Kate spoke to me about possibly changing the in-service days to not always fall on a Friday, which affects their schedule and their specials in particular. So we'd love to move those dates around. So if the board is fine with that, then we will repost this on the website, get it back out to staff, because it's different than what's out there. And we would, you know, correct it in all the places that it exists.
Is it simply being moved to the Thursday before the Friday, or they're all moved around? I did not print them down.
So they are moved around sometimes. So it could be a Thursday, it could be a Wednesday, it's a Tuesday. So we didn't, we should try not to pick the same day.
Oh, it seems like a very, very good solution to that problem.
Any questions or concerns from the board?
So the biggest piece will be, I will share this with the bus company, because they will now have a Rollinsford calendar, a Summersworth calendar, and a Marshwood calendar that all do different things. So they're the people I'm most concerned about. Like, I'll get them up and I'll have conversations and make sure it's set. And I will also share with Connie to make sure she follows up with that as honest.
But it was already different from the Marshwood calendar. I mean,
it
our,
is.
Our service days were not the same as theirs anyway, so.
No, they followed the Summersworth schedule, the in-service days. Mm-hmm. So now it'll be, you know, they'll just see buses all the time, possibly, or not. I don't know.
I see buses all the time.
They can manage it.
Yeah.
Do we need, again, do we need to, I guess we do, we need to accept the change to the...
I make a motion to accept the change to the calendar as proposed.
Okay. One second.
All right, all in favor, please, by saying aye.
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 Thank you.
All right, and another, the last action item on our list, last time, or perhaps it was, anyway, at our last meeting, we discussed that there would be a memorandum of understanding with the Marshwood billing. And basically what has changed is simply the frequency of billing. And I don't know if you've had a chance to look at it. It was very simple. It simply says we will now bill monthly. And they'll say, they say for what when they will bill each month. And I believe it's like a month and a half later. So any questions, concerns, thoughts on that?
Do you need a motion on that?
You do?
Because it's a change to the contract.
Well, I'll be three for three. I'll make a motion to change the billing to monthly as proposed.
Second?
All right.
And then the motion is to accept the memorandum of understanding.
That's
I think it was. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Is that effective at the beginning?
Next school year.
Yes.
Yes.
Yep.
Let's make sure we all listen. Make sure
yes. Starting.
Gets very
September 5th. Or October 1st, if you can send us. We get an update.
Next is the financial update on the budget. All right. Is there any reports? Anything to be? All right. Any questions? Concerns? I do have a couple comments. I think so. Any concerns? All right. So at one of our at a number of our last meetings, we can all see that there's a balance at the moment of about $77,000, and at one of our meetings we discussed wanting there to be about $100,000. So there's a couple different things we could do to sort of ensure that there's going to be about $100,000. Actually, hearing this evening for the first time that our bonus offer is not being accepted, that really does it. That puts us up at that $100,000. So there's that. One of the other options would have been to reduce the amount we put in the special ed reserve fund, if indeed we feel we wanted to continue to do that. to make it be about $100,000.
So because it was a warrant article, we're not going to be able to touch that.
Okay, because it was a warrant article, we can't, it says up to, so we can't even change it.
So it's worded the way you would.
All right, then that, there goes that idea. Can't do that one. So, all right, so it is what it is essentially at this point. Okay, it is what it is. We'll see what it is at the end of the year when it comes down to that. Any other, anything else on the budget? All right.
All right, yeah.
Yeah, no, go ahead.
Care upkeep of equipment. That's leveled out for the year. It's at zero now. It's just
it's estimated that.
I apologize.
It's estimated that it's going to be
I'm looking at it.
Everything that's highlighted in yellow in the backup has been encumbered.
Yes, essentially it still has almost $4,000 still encumbered. So the balance is zero.
This is not the final budget.
Right.
Yeah.
Is it? Anyone else? Okay, then we'll move on to new business. At this point in the proceedings, we're going to take a moment out and we're going to recognize someone who will not be with us at our next meeting. So, just going to take a moment here and we know, Jenny, that you didn't want any hoo-ha. Believe me, this is the least hoo-ha we can manage. Believe me, you are not going to. I'm going to say a few words, offer it up to anyone else to say a few words as we get there. So, Jenny Mosca is an educator of the highest degree. She has state and national recognition as one of the 2006 Milken educators. And for those of you who don't know, one is recognized in every state in the union. The search committee that hired her 7 years ago cited her energy, enthusiasm, and leadership, all of which have proven out over the last 7 years. When I started working with Jenny 5 years ago, I knew I had a lot to learn. I am a skeptical student, seldom accepting things at face value, and often questioning even seasoned professionals. Jenny accepted the challenge, and I'm going to take just a moment longer to share some of what I've learned. A good superintendent emulates nature in that she abhors a bed. So a good superintendent will fill in the missing pieces, the black holes, by herself if needed. Aside from the incredible volume of administrative and educational responsibilities a superintendent must fulfill, she also must work with diverse and ever-changing boards. If a board is hands-off, she steps in to lead and ensures nothing gets missed. If a board is hands-on, she steps back and provides support. By any measure, Jenny Mosca is not just a good superintendent, she is a great one. She can aptly be called a force of nature. Thank you, Jenny, for always setting high standards for yourself, for SAU 56, and for the Rollinsford School District. Thank you for always putting students first, and thank you for making this board the best it can be. You will be missed.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Others?
Well, I'm the only one here from first there, so, but I'll tell you, you clearly have gone through a lot in this district, a lot in our shared districts. Never a dull moment. But I echo a lot of what you said. You've had a lot on your plate. You put in Retirement is not something, I mean, we've more than earned it. And I guess we all can say, you know, yeah, absolutely, we're going to miss you. We are going to miss you. But at the same time, we want you to be able to enjoy your retirement. And I'm sure you're going to. You'll miss the cold weather. Anyway, thank you for everything you've done.
I'd like to echo what you said. I really want to tell you, I appreciate all the help, you know, for me being new, you know, taking on this role. It's a little bit out of my comfort zone when you really came along the way. Educating me with all the procedural stuff and all that. So,
thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, I haven't been on the board yet. As a parent in this town, thank you for all your time and your hard work and your energy and your love that you've given back to the town. We all appreciate it. And we will really miss hearing your voice at
5:30.
Several times every winter.
Thank you.
Well said.
Thank you.
And to help you enjoy at least your first month or two, perhaps that will that will come in handy while you're still here in New England.
Okay. Thank you very much.
On the board.
Thank you. Thanks. It's been an honor to be here. So thank you for the support and for being as supportive as you've been for 7 years. It's a tough job. So if you don't have board support, it's a very difficult job. So thank you for that. I appreciate it.
We will now get back to the regularly scheduled program. And we'll get into old business. Community connections, and while we discuss that, one of the things, I think, we have a couple different things to discuss there. One is sort of our making very official our goals from our workshop, and then how we're going to proceed from there on. And the other is, I think, the student survey, right? Those are two things we know, there are other things. So let's right now, why don't we just talk about our goals for the coming year and then what we came up out of our workshop with. We came up with three goals, and they came out in this order. Number one, to place the teachers on the appropriate salary step based on their qualifications and experience. That's our number one goal for the coming year. Our second goal is to communicate consistently and clearly with all stakeholders. And our third goal was to investigate ways to work more closely with other town boards and committees to pool resources, save time, and save money where possible. Erin, would you like to talk about sort of one of our first steps in sort of communicating?
Sure. So in an attempt to communicate more often, more consistently and more clearly to update our taxpayers and our townspeople and parents and students, all stakeholders, on how we're working towards achieving these goals, we decided to send out a monthly newsletter. Just something brief to sort of help people who can't make it to the meetings or have questions to really get a glimpse into what we're working on. And we're going to be writing frequently asked questions and things like that. So hopefully that will be helpful for spreading information. And we're also looking for feedback from the community in terms of what you'd like to see covered in that newsletter. So I think our first one will come out in June. And we'll talk a little bit about the goals that Judy just outlined. And provide a little bit more information about where we're going this year, just to kind of get things kicked off.
Anyone else want to make any comments? And when we say monthly newsletter, we mean like as close to monthly as possible. There may be, who knows what's going to happen, but the goal is to keep it moving. Some very good folks here on the board who've been working on it, so thank you for that. All right, so, and then we have the survey results, which, do you want to discuss those? And we did a survey a number of people, Emily was part of it, and some other folks, a survey both of Boston Grade School and of Marshwood students.
Yes.
In both cases. So do you want to, Mary, a few things about it?
Sure. I think we've all got to look at the results. And I think overall, all surveys were very positive. Boston Grade School, there was a positive feedback from the survey. And, you know, it was evident to folks, you know, some of the comments about their, you know, weren't initially happy about the configurations. Some were happy that things were changing again. Others found that, you know, they were apprehensive at first, but realized they didn't have to worry after they experienced it. So, you know, reading through the comments, I didn't get to see whether some of the comments were one-off of a comment or multiple comments from the results of the survey presented. So I'd have to go back in and actually look, you know, to quantify exactly how many. But I think overall, looking at the information, the comments, and the reading, it was very positive.
Yeah, I also thought it was positive on both in both ways. Positive for Boston Grade School and positive at Marshwood. It was very positive. I think it's really pretty good for the second year transition to Marshwood to have such really such positive feedback. There were a couple of one-off ones there, but obviously sort of an outlier. But again, things did we take it all in, so. See what we can do to work with it. So again, good work on the board getting that out, and you know, many, many thanks to the Boston Grade School staff for getting those kids ready to go up there and keeping them on their toes here.
And I assume that was shared with as you and Chief, I said, I'm probably here in public, and I'll share with the other day.
Great. Are there any other community connections? Transportation.
I have one.
Wow, I think we went up too much without discussing it, but yes, thank you.
I can't have a meeting without a look. So you had asked me to contact Dr. Nash regarding the late bus for next year. So I was able to track down a cost. So it will be $31.98 per day for next year. And that would start on Monday, September 11th. 2017 and end on Thursday, June 7th, 2018 for a total of 135 days for a cost of $4,317.30.
It's almost like they knew we had $5,000 in the budget, isn't it? Amazing. We've been told, and again, I'm not sure this has been shared widely, but we've been told that there are 5 to 10 Rollinsford riders on that bus. We learned that at our joint meeting. And that was only going to grow next year, would be my assumption. So, again, this is. our best financial option, it sounds like. So, do we need to do like a consensus kind of thing to carry on with it?
I'll get back to John Caverly tomorrow and say, I assume the board is fine with that and to plan on starting on September 11th.
Concerns, discussion? Okay. So I think
you have exhausted it, I think. It's always good to keep, keep monitoring
it. And it's going to stay, it's going to stay on the agenda. We will keep discussing it. Hopefully get more feedback from students and what else goes forward as well. So so by consensus, yes, we will go forward with that. Marshwood contract items, these are just things that we want to start keeping in mind. We still have a list. You have that list somewhere.
So I have that list, and it sits in with the contract in my desk. I can either leave it with Connie, or maybe what I'll do, Judy, is type it up and give you a copy.
Send a copy just so, and I can make sure it's with the contract as well. Thank you. We go forward. And as I think most of you know, it's because in another year, I think starting next year, we'll be negotiating the extension of that contract. So we're ready to do that. And the last old business is the late start time at Marshwood. Last we knew you were still waiting for.
Yeah, I have no update this time.
Okay. I have a slight update, that late start. I was visiting relatives in Europe, and my cousin's daughter brought her 12-year-old son. And he was practicing his English, so I said, well, in the United States, we're starting to talk about, oh, and he was sleeping the first day, so he couldn't come. And it was like, 10 o'clock in the morning. He says, in the United States, they're talking about late starts. And he said, oh, yes, here too. He said, we've had to fill out surveys, we'll have to do all this, and of course, his father's sitting there going, the work's going to happen, and they'll just stay up later. But anyway, it's so obviously it's happening around the world. I thought it was very interesting.
But the statistics say that supposedly they don't just stay up later. That's what the studies are saying. So
yes, and I thought it was interesting that they were surveying students. So, anyway, that's my little anecdotal late start. All right, future meetings. By convention, we don't usually meet in July, so our next meeting is August 10th. And as many of you, of course, are parents of kids here and parents in state, so you know all the things that are happening at Rollinsford Grade School. The one I'd like to make sure that the board is well aware of, and some of you may be attending as parents, is of course the sixth grade recognition at the American Legion on June 19th.
I can bet that Emily and I will be there.
You can bet that at least the two of you will be there, okay? And I will be there as well. It's a lovely evening, though. They do a great job recognizing and honoring those students. I'm going to get closing comments now from visitors, unless there's any other. Okay. Closing comments from visitors.
Are the results of the survey that you took?
Name and address.
Tamara Nijikowski, Silver Street, sorry. Are the results of the survey that you took about the school going to be made public? Whatever you prepare for that, so that we can see.
We actually haven't talked about it, but I don't see. I
that would be my question. I guess I was. And I guess it would be.
Yeah, I mean, it was not. It was not meant to keep them private. So I guess we hadn't thought about how best to make them public. Well, so the answer is yes. I think they would be. Is that?
Can I also ask how many respondents you had?
57 or 66, that
means in which something for the grade school?
Grade 7.
For the grade school.
60. Yeah, I don't know. And there was for the middle school and high school.
Yeah.
44 is the number that's sticking in my head.
So it was close to 100. If you add it together.
We felt it was a very good response. It was better than our first survey from the first year, but better response, better numbers of respondents.
So I just, I don't know if we figure out what's the best way to kind of share that. I mean, if that would be.
We can put it on the website.
The better resource on the website?
Yeah.
On the SAU website, on the grade school website. We'll find a way.
Put them on both.
They'll be on both.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So if you send me to me, I'll put them on the SAU site and be able to put them on.
Other comments by closing comments? Nancy Dyer?
I'm just curious about the enrollment, because I didn't hear a number.
Yep, it's stable. It has not changed since last time. It's 156 in the grade school, and it has not changed in Summersworth or in Marshwood. It's the same as
okay, thank you.
Celia?
Celia Lee, Washington Street. I had a couple of questions that I'm not sure you could answer, but maybe take to the Marshall Board next time you go there. But I know there's a regional agreement for access to different programs that Marshall doesn't offer, but I'm wondering about advanced higher ed classes, like college-level classes. If they don't offer something, do they offer a college course somewhere? Like, if they don't offer German at the school, could you go take it at Newman or something like that? And
actually, we have a board member who has an idea. Dean has an idea of an answer to that.
There are AP courses offered. I mean, you have to apply for that or work that through the school administration. But I believe there are avenues for students.
Within the school, like if you exhaust all of them in the school, is there an option?
Tell you what, let's look. You think so, but what, right? Is that your answer? So we'll. We'll get an official answer.
I've had experience with that myself. On behalf of the REC committee, there was a question brought up that the school board had applied to have a shed put up at the school. And we're wondering if that was in the process or where it was going so that the REC committee can be aware of that.
There will be a shed, and it will be built and paid.
So yeah, I had asked last time I talked to Kelly, because there's so many of you asking questions, and I've told everybody like six times. So I had said, as soon as you, and I know you've hired the director, I'd be happy to sit down with the director and Brittany and talk about all those things, because I've given everybody the information, but there's so many of you trying to pull it together. And I think it would just be easier to have like one point of person, like point of contact and liaison for you guys, because you're right, it will affect you guys, but we do that, and we knew we were trying to do it at the same time as the meeting, so you guys could not be disrupted totally.
Okay,
thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Gary. We appreciate you working with them and one point person.
In regards to next year's bus routes, have they gone up yet? Or are you still getting registrations? Or
yeah, bus routes won't go up till August.
Okay. And they'll be up on the website.
Absolutely.
They'll be up on the SAU website. Yeah. And I don't think we put them up on an alternate route. So.
We haven't, because we have not.
And they do want to be.
And then my last question is on the newsletter you're trying to get out as a board. How do you plan on disseminating it to the public?
Oh, it will be mailed. It will be mailed. It will be mailed to every household.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Are there any further closing comments by the public?
I just wanted to thank the school Tracy. Board, Tracy Laurie, 496 for Harris. Just wanted to let the school board and everybody know that we're not quite all done our sports in Summerwood High School. We have a student that is going to New England's this Saturday for javelin. So went to the States, then went to the League of Champions, and now will be has placed fifth in the state for both division for one, two, and three, and is going to New England's on Saturday. So we're not quite done all our spring track and field stuff.
Great. Any further closing comments by visitors? Any closing comments by the board? We do have non-public, so we'll be sticking around. For those of you that we won't see again, have a good summer. Put you all back here. Motion to go into non-public.
Thank you.